He sneers. All right, fine. If you say they're fake, then maybe they are. How should I know? I didn't make the things. I bought them. So I'm the one that was ripped off here, not you. Now, since there's no deal, I'm not going to waste my time here any longer. Bye. Should I attack? If I attack, we might get a few stim packs out of the deal and weapons and stuff that they have. Let's try. Shall be merchant with an eye patch. Oh. I should have bothered to use one of my own stim packs first, right? Points. 43. 44. These guys have a lot, unfortunately. Well, I have to go to inventory anyway, don't I, to get my gun out. In case I run out of ammo, let's put the other gun there. Do these things give you hit points? No. Thirty-six out of 58. Unfortunately, I can't fire this round. Nope, they're both 5, all right. I'm gonna stand my ground for right now, then. I'd run away, but I don't want to run away and leave him in the lurch. So I'm gonna stand my ground and take the added AC. These guys are ranged anyway. Ow.
You have died. Your village is lost.
Oh.
Doomed to die of starvation.
Okay, I guess I died during one of the pauses for the animation. Either he got lucky? Let me come back to that. Because he might have just got a lucky critical. Unfortunately, I can't see it. Yeah, I'm going to have to take the risk and uninstall the mod, take out those animations, and try again. But first, let me see if I can get past this combat. This time I have a lot more hit points. And I'm already armed. Try to get away from these guys a little bit more. Yeah, I don't think I can do it. Huh. He hit the... Yeah, hold on. Your ancestors had deserted you, Crom says. Merchant was hit instead of you. Let's see if we can possibly survive this. We took out one. Or, well, they took out one. I used my doctor's kit instead of stim packs. 54 out of 58, okay. I try to get a little distance. I'll try to pick out that guy over there. Hope you don't die too quickly. Yeah, I hope I don't die at all. So the reason, guys, is this... Someone asked again, so the reason this is happening is because of the added animations with the Fallout 2 restoration mod. So I found on a forum when recording, it screws up something. So if I wasn't recording, it would run fine. But since I am, 60% to hit this guy. 61 to 2. Yeah, for 15 points. Yeah, maybe I should work together with him, though. My blade grows thirsty. Okay, I guess he's attacking with a special spear animation. Let's see. Warren scowls down at his recently slashed arm. That's pretty cool. Now I think from this distance, I won't hit... What's his name? How's he doing, by the way? They're not shooting at him. You see a giant, heavily muscled warrior. His bronze skin carries the scars of countless battles. What? He has 400 out of 41 hit points? That might be 40? I don't know. Oh, I hit him. Head warrior was hit instead of merchant. I'm sorry. Now he's down to 41 hit points. That's a bug. Okay, I hit him. I didn't mean to. Hopefully he doesn't attack me. Gotta feed you to the dogs. Oh. Yeah, I'm dead. I didn't realize. Huh.
Rest in peace. Chosen one.
Thank you. Okay, I couldn't get as lucky as the other time. I couldn't get them to hit him. And they're tough. If I had the leather armor, then maybe it would be, you know, feasible, but I'm just gonna let them leave, actually. Okay. Hopefully Crom is satisfied with that. If I ever see that cheating dog again, I'll take great pleasure in cleaving his ugly skull. However, you did well in spotting his deceit. I see I made a wise choice in trusting you, girl. You're welcome to stay among us and treat our tribe as your own. However, I may call on your aid again in the future. Thanks for your help. Yeah, let's not go down this way. No problem. The giant warrior grins as he watches you approach. By the gods, I nearly forgot how gorgeous you are. Do you need something, girl? Yeah, you're sure paying attention. I didn't even budge. I was wondering if I could ask you a couple questions. Of course. What can you tell me about this village? Let's see. Most members of this village actually hail from three smaller tribes that decided to unite many years ago in order to keep from dying off. It creates an interesting mix of customs and dialects. More importantly, it creates a good mix of women. Beyond that, there's not much to say. It's a simple village where we struggle to forge a simple existence. Alright, thanks. Can I ask you something else? Of course. You look like you've been through a lot. I was wondering what your story is. Yes, I suppose I've been through a lot. I come from a tribe far to the north. When I was 15, we were attacked by savages. I awoke that day as a boy, but by the time the sun set on that grim scene, I had slayed my way to manhood. Every man, woman, and child was dead, except for me. But what's life without battle and strife? It either breaks a man, or it forges him into steel. I wear my scars with pride. So what did you do then? I piled the bodies and watched them burn into the night, then gathered what I could and went wandering, spent time with various tribes, fought many battles, spent a little time among the civilized men, but I tired of them quickly. Too many honorless dogs hiding behind their guns. I'd rather enjoy a good battle of flesh and steel. I'm not a complicated man. Give me battles and feasts, wine and women. What else matters in this grim world? So how'd you end up here? I came here a couple years ago. This tribe took me in and treated me well. They offered to make me their head warrior, which I obviously accepted. I've enjoyed it here, next to the great salt water, but I feel the wanderlust growing within me. Someday soon, I believe I'll move on and see what the gods have in store for me next. Is there anything going on here that I can help you with? Actually, Marley looks like he's having some trouble with the well. If you feel like helping, maybe you could go see what the problem is. Okay. Let's see if we can help Marley. Are you Marley? What do you want? I see you're having some trouble with that well. What's wrong, exactly? What's wrong? I dropped the rope, that's what's wrong. He shifts uncomfortably. I was fastening a new rope to the well, and then I looked up and saw this fine young maiden stretching in the sunlight. Spirits of lust distracted me, and the rope slipped from my hands and... What's it to you, anyway, outworlder? Unless you got a new rope for me, you'd be wasting my time. You have to admit to the others what happened. Try to keep your spirits of lust under control. Ah, why not? The rope's heavy, but it's rather cheap, right? As a matter of fact, I do. I'll see if I can fix that well for you. See if we can get even good, better with this tribe. They might be able to help me out in some way. So is the well fixed yet? Or what? Not yet, I'm afraid. I'm laughing at the other response. So I can take the bucket, apparently. A medium-sized bucket used to haul water from a well. Alright, so if we go... Well, no, I can't attach anything there. I can attach the rope there, I guess. This well is missing its rope and bucket. Well, I guess I take the bucket, put it in inventory, and attach them both. That's a 1-pound bucket. Welcome, warrior. Oh, they like me now. Who's this dude? Welcome, warrior. Okay. I don't think we need repair skill. I think I'll just attach the rope. Hopefully I don't need it anytime soon. Did I attach the rope? I did not attach the rope. Well, at least it has a working rope now. Perhaps you can fix it. Okay, I'm verifying yes indeed. The rope is gone from my inventory. Attach the bucket. I should just about do it. The well is working fine again. The well is already fixed, remember? I wanted to pull up the bucket. Alright. So the well is fixed, yes? With the bucket attached and everything? Okay, if I don't answer him, he'll get pissed off. Yes, it's all done. The corner of his mouth twitches up into the hint of a smile. Ah, I suppose you outworlders aren't all bad, after all. Here, take this money. The spirits tell me you'll be needing this more than I. Ooh! What did he just give me? I think he just gave me 200... No. 150, I think. I don't know, gold pieces, whatever the hell this is. Well, I got experience. You fixed the tribe's well and get 400 experience points and 10 karma. So my karma with Umbra Tribe is liked. People wave and greet you whenever you go in this area. Everyone has heard talk of you, and they like what they've heard. Nice! Even better than accepted is liked. May your ancestors guide you well. I thought all outworlders were evil. It is not so. Okay. Can I mess around with pots and stuff now? Maybe I can take this shovel. Well, do they have evil plants too? Can I take this fish? Agricultural cart. Oh, I'm at my weight capacity? I guess I don't need the shovel. It is 10 pounds. I'll take another fish instead. Let's see what trouble we can get into. What is that? Oh, it's just something on top of the steak. Something will get pissed off and attack. It's empty anyway. This one. Alright. A gecko pelt and healing powder. People don't seem to be pissed off. Hopefully they don't mind taking this stuff. Actually, just taking that and that. A shelf. Another knife. I'll leave the knife. I'm starting to get overweight, aren't I? That's even with the rope subtracted. Alright, let's check in here first. This one's not guarded. A small young man dressed in rags. Fish? Oh, nice. Oops. I'm at my maximum. You know what? Screw all that. Gecko pelt. Healing powder, thank you. And why not? Irradiated fruit. So far, all is well. And I'm not attacking or anything. I'm still liked. Yes, okay. Young man dressed in rags. He appears deep in thought. Upon noticing you, he does a startled jump, then quickly regains his composure. Yes, Outworlder? If you come seeking spiritual guidance, I'm afraid I'm not up to it at the moment. Perhaps some other time. It seems like something is troubling you. Is there anything I could help you with? He contemplates for a moment, then sighs. This is rather embarrassing to admit, but you see, I've never actually believed in spirits, the afterlife, any of it. I know what you're thinking. What good is a shaman that doesn't believe? It's just that, well, it was either this or I take up a spear and hunt geckos with the warriors. Do I look like a warrior to you? Wait, don't answer that. Well, I could show him the spirit. So if you don't believe, then how do you tend to the spiritual needs of the village? Well, up until just recently, I was merely the underling of the village shaman. That was easy. I just had to follow his lead. Then he went for a drunken midnight swim in the great salt water, and, well, I suddenly found myself promoted. I didn't think it would be so bad. I figured I could just spout off some mystical mumbo-jumbo, and everyone would be happy. But no. The very day that I acquire the title of shaman, I find myself dealing with something that's way over my head. What happened? There's an actual lost spirit roaming the woods just south of the village. It's true. I've seen her with my own eyes. A pretty girl with the blank look of the dead. The sight chilled me to the very core. The moment I saw her, I pissed myself and ran back as fast as I could. Well, you believe now, then, don't you? The others expect me to go back and guide her into the mists, but how can I? I'm too petrified to go near her again. Unless you got an extra pair of balls laying around that could pin onto you. So what can I do to help? You could go to her, try to figure out why she lingers in the mortal realm. She appears in the woods to the south at night. If you could find out anything that could help me, I'd greatly appreciate it. Yeah, I know exactly where she is. I'll look into it. After I'm done helping myself to all your goodies. Alright, maybe this guy will let me in now. Heard about the good deeds you've been doing. Since I was wrong about you, or see I was wrong about you, forgive me for being rude. For being a rude man, friend. Go on in and peep the big man. He'd be waiting for you. Thank you. And he steps aside just like that. I gotta open. Okay. Curtain, huh? The curtain looks like it was created by primitive Medes, but it is very functional. What kind of pot you got in here? Alright, ancient-looking tribal. The old man smokes his pipe and watches you with dull gray eyes that seem to bore into your soul. He motions for you to sit across from him in the smoke-filled tent. We are most grateful for your services, wanderer. He takes a long hit off his pipe. The spirits, they have much to say about you. Much indeed. Tell me, what brings you to our village? I want a quest for the Holy Gek. Do you know anything about this? The Holy Gek. He takes a long hit off his pipe. There's a creature that we sometimes hunt. Sometimes it hunts us. A gecko. No, I sense that's not what you seek. I'm afraid your Holy Gek is beyond my ken. Let me ask you something else. What can this old man do for you? Is there anything else that needs to be done around here? Thank you, child, but I am content. Perhaps others are not so. Ask around the village. Alright, let's go seek out the spirit. Let's also save. Anything around here? There's nothing. There's a lot of wilderness here, but. Oh, supposedly that goes somewhere friendly. I wonder if the rest of there's a more to the village if it continues on that way. I was disappointed I couldn't defeat those guys, but what are you gonna do? Oh, it's daytime now. I need to wait until night. A pile of rocks? Not very interesting. Get the knife. Is that a special knife? No. It's just a knife. Alright. Let's wait around. Hopefully I can wait here. 10:41, it should be dark. Oh no no no, that's 22:41, never mind. Let's rest for 6 hours. Where's the spirit? Come, spirit. Will she not appear if I'm here? Maybe killing the rats banished her? How about the witching hour? Well, let me just look. No? Okay, about midnight. There she is. Can I talk to her now? He said that he loved me, that we could start over together. How could he do this? Who did this to you? Can you hear me? It's all a lie. He doesn't love me at all. Oh, he's got a knife. It hurts. The look in his eyes. So cold, so... If you can hear me, tell me who's hurting you. Who did this? He's walking away now. He's leaving me here to die alone. How could this happen? Please, just give me a name. Give me something more to work with. It wasn't supposed to be like this. You said you wanted to start a family with me. Oh, it's so cold. I think I'm dying. No. This isn't real. You would never do this to me, Thorg. I love you. Nessa will always love you. Thorg, huh? Thank you, Nessa. That's all I needed to hear. So lonely in the dark. So very lonely. The blood. It never stops flowing. Why won't this pain end? Don't worry, Nessa. I'm going to help you find peace soon. Alright, let's return to the shaman. Quote unquote. What passes for the village shaman? He believes now, though. It's gotta be something. What's attacking me? Oh. Whatever. It was beyond what do you call it? Who's Thorg? You're back. Did you discover anything about the lost spirit? I spoke to... listened to the spirit. It seems she was betrayed and murdered by her lover, someone named Thorg. Thorg? He was the shaman that I served as an apperceive under. Wow, I knew he was a bit of an asshole, but I didn't take him for a slayer of pretty young girls. I suppose a guilty conscience helps to explain that drunken midnight swim that led to his death. So Thorg is a murderer. How about that? So what now? Now I suppose I have to send her into the mists. I think I'll be able to do it, but I need you to come with me. There's just no way I'd be able to face her alone. See, he's so nervous, he's stammering. And none of the others in the village will go. They believe it's an ill omen for a non-shaman to encounter a lost spirit. Okay. Don't worry. I'll help you get through this. Shit, oh shit, oh shit. No, I can do this. Okay, Nessa? Oh, so cold and alone. Nessa, you must hear my voice. I am calling to you from the mortal world. I hear someone. Who is there? I am the shaman of this village. You must enter the mists. There you will find peace. Well, he couldn't hear me, or she couldn't hear me. Yes. Yes, I see the mist now. I see spirits beckoning to me. Go to them, Nessa. Go into the mist and join your ancestors. I'm not alone anymore. Cool. You relieve the tribe shaman of his troubles and gain 500 experience points and 25 karma. Still in liked status. You've given me the courage I need to serve this village. I can't thank you enough. Yeah, you can help me by giving me stuff. I think I already looked in these. How goes things, warrior? Alright, let's see if anyone needs any more help before we go. I guess we're done here. Good to see you again, girl. If you've got a moment, I could use your assistance.
Sure. What do you need?
Two of our hunters, Seren and Jerem, have not yet returned from the hunting ground, and some people are starting to worry. They're two of our best warriors, and I'd hate to think something has happened to them. I'd go search for them myself, but if the villagers saw me take such a personal interest in the matter, I fear they'd assume the worst. I'd rather not get people riled up until I know what's going on. So will you seek them out for me? Besides, I'm sure they'll turn up soon. Bye! All right, but where should I look? Check the hunting grounds to the north. Okay, that's what's there. The quickest way to get there is through the cave to the west, next to the Great Salt Water. Normally, I wouldn't advise taking that route since it's in danger of collapsing, but it's important that you make haste. Just tread carefully through the cave, and you should be fine. You want me to pass through a cave that's about to collapse? Shit, I just remembered I have to go save my tribe. Alright, I'll hurry and try to find them. Okay. Do you bring news of the Lost Hunters? Not yet. I'll keep looking. Oh, so through the cave here, then. And they don't mind me having my gun out, apparently. Oh, there's more stuff here. Look at all the fish. Would you be grabbing that? That's my fish. A fisherwoman. Excuse me, but could you do me a small favor? I'm a little busy here, and I don't know if I can leave this pot unattended. Sure, what do you need? I'm running low on wood for this fire. If you could collect some more for me, I'd really appreciate it. I'd do it myself, but I'm afraid this pot will boil over if I leave it unattended. I'm sure some logs can be found in the nearby forest. Three bundles will be perfect. It'll be my pleasure. You'll help me? Great. Let me know when you've collected them. I know where that is. Another sharpened spear. I don't suppose I have to use my lock-picking skill on these. I do want to grab that fish, though. Let's see what's in the pot. Nothing. More fish. I don't carry that much. About one. I didn't even pick up one. What do I not need? These probably don't weigh anything. I'm thinking the fish. I don't know, let's drop one thing of boots. Oh, I have two firewood already. So she wants three, right? I love fish. How heavy is the fish? I'll have to come back here. 5 pounds per fish. Yeah, I can carry that much. I wish I could carry this stuff. What do I have here?
Sharpened pole. I don't think a sharpened pole would give me that much. What's this? Oh, that's the stuff I dropped. So this is my own sharpened spear. How about I drop these sharpened poles? 3 pounds each. I'll drop them all. That's much better. Halt. What you want? The head warrior told me I'm allowed to enter the cave to search for the missing hunters. Oh yeah, me no see those guys in a while. Hope they okay. Head warrior say okay to enter? Fine with me. Thanks. Let you know if I need anything. Welcome, friend. Welcome, friend. And this is the ocean. Pretty cool. Anything else here? Not really. Okay, so I have to search for the hunters, and I have to find, get firewood for her. So I will do that next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. And always, seek adventure.